Hey, what's up, guys? This is Sean here again. So this time, let's take a look at LeetCode problem number 827, making a large island. All right, so you're given like a 2D grid, which consists of only 0 or 1. And you can change at most 1, 0 to 1. And after which you need to get the maximum size. I mean, the size of the largest island, and the island is like a four directionally connected group of ones. Right, so a few examples here, right? I mean, so this is like actually another extension problem of the number of islands. But for this one, you know, so for example, these are the most basic examples. Let's say we have 1, 0 and 0, 1. Right, so I mean, since we can only change at most 1, 0 to 1, basically we can change either this one to 1 or this one to 1. And after that, the island we have here is like what? It's like 3. That's why the answer is 3 here. And here is another one, 1, 1, 1, 0, right? And then here, actually, this is the only 0 we can change. That's why the answer is 4. And the last one is 1, 1, 1, 1, right? So in this case, there's nothing to be changed. Basically, this is the an special case where if there's no zero in the in this 2D grid, the answer is the total number of the entire size of the grid, right? That's a special case. So, and here are some constraints like the length and the width is like within 50s, right? And that's and the value is within 0 or 1. So, I mean, I think a common thinking process it will be like this, you know. So since those are the like the easy cases, you know, let's think about some general cases. You know, let's say we have a pretty big 2D grid here, and we have some islands here, right? We have some islands. So this is, sorry. Let's say we have an island like this, right? So this is one of the island, and then we have this island. We have this island. It could be in any shape, right? It doesn't really matter. So this island, right? Yeah, basically, you know, we could have like some isolated islands in this 2D grid, and we have to find out like what are the biggest island we can get by trying to connecting some of the islands together, right? Because you know, let's say we have some zeros here, because as you guys, so all within the islands they're all ones, right? Because the ones will consist of an island. So our purpose is to find all the islands first, and then we'll loop through all the zeros, and for each zeros, we'll try to see if the zeros is connecting to any of the islands in four directions. Okay, and basically we'll try each of the zeros, and we'll try to check the connected island in four directions, and then we'll try to add the size. We'll accumulate the size of all the other connected islands. And that's gonna be our intuition here, right? And to do that, you know, first thing first, we have to pre-process the 2D grid so that we can get all the islands and also the size of each island. So to do that, I mean, I think there are two ways you can do it. First one is the DFS. Right, so you can do a DFS, but after doing the DFS, you have to assign the an index for this island because you know when we try to check the connected islands, it could be connected to any part of this island, right? So that's something we might need to think about. How can we assign the index for all the elements, right? And actually, I think for me, a easier way to do this is, of course, it's a union find. Right. I think for this problem, it's more suitable for a unifying data structure because, you know, for a unifying, once we have union all the ones in within this island, I mean all the elements in this island, they're all pointing to the same root. So it will be easier for us to find the same island, also to find the size of the islands. Right, so because we can also easily update the size of the islands when we do the union. So I'll be using a union find to find all the islands, and after that, I'll be looping through the all each zeros, and for each zeros, we'll try to check all four directions, right, and then we'll go from there. All right. So with that being said, you know, let's try to implement this problem here. All right. So a few things first. Let's try to get the size of the grid, right? So we have an M and then we have an N here. So that's that. And to do the union find, we're gonna have like to use this parent, right? So for those who are still not quite familiar with union find, I'm not going to talk too much details about a union find. So you guys can look it up on the internet, or I believe in my previous videos, I also talk about some union finds implementations. But here, I'll just focus on the implementation parts. Okay, so for the union find, so to initialize union finds, you have to have like what a list of the parents at the beginning. So each element out in the union find, they have their the value. I mean the parent of each item, each number, it's its own value. So which means we have in total m times n values in this 2D grid. That's why I'm going to use an integer to initialize this union find, right? So we have a range of m times n. And then since we're also going to maintain the size of each the union find component, I'm going to have like a size here, right? Size here of the m times n, and I'm going to initialize with one because you know each at least each item will has a one, size one. That's the base, right? And then we're gonna have like two functions, right? The find, right? So the find, we have a if parent dot x equals to, sorry, not equal to x, and then we'll use your recursive call here. So this recursive call will not only help us find the parents, but it will also do a path compression so that it will make this find method has the time complexity from on to o1, okay, of x, right? So and then in the end we return the parents of x. So that's the find, and then we have a union. Right, so the union is similar, like the x and the y here. So we have a root one, right? So the root one is the find x. So we find the root for x, and then we find the root for y. And then we only do the unions when the root is different, right? Here, I mean here, I actually to make this union method complete, we are supposed to have like a ranking property for each of the roots. Basically, you know, here we're always trying to assign the components that has a lower ranking to the components that has a higher ranking, so that we can improve the performance even more. But here I'm not going to do that. I'll always assign the parents. I always assign the root two to root one, just to make it simple. Okay. And then after that, we are also going to update the size of R1, right, by accumulating the size of R2. That's how we roll up the size of R1, because we always merge the R2 with R1, right? So that's that. Okay, so that's the union find helper functions, and now build the islands. Okay. let's build islands. So to build islands, let's try to do a I in range M here, right? And then we have a for J in range N here. So for this kind of 2D problems, we already have like this kind of four directions, right? So we have 0 and 1, and we have 0 minus 1, the 1 0, and then minus 1 0. So here, when we build the islands, we we check, right, if the current grid is one, and then I will look for four directions actually. So here since we're traversing the cell from top down and from left to right, we only need to try to union with the ones above the current one and on the left of the current one. We don't have to worry about the right side and down below, because the next one will take care of that. That's why we can save. So for the direction here, I'm not going to use the entire directions here. So I'll just manually write the two directions here. So minus 1, 0 is the ones above us, right, above the current one, and then the ones on the left is 0 dot minus 1. So we only need to merge to union with those two possible cell, and then we have a new I equals to I plus D0, right? Then new J equals to J plus D1. Okay, now some sanity check, right, the boundary check. So if this thing goes to smaller than new I, and then M, right, and same thing for the new J, right, 0 between the 0 and N, and right, and what, and the new I and new J is 1, right, and then we union them together. So since we have a new I and J, and the way we're initialized the parents, we convert that into an integer, into 1D list here. So we have to do a little calculation here. So it's going to be I times M plus J, right? So that's the first key. Second key is the same, right? New I times M plus J. That's the second key. All right, cool. So after this nested for loop here, we have find all the islands, and we also have the size of each of the islands, right? So the next is just to, now we try each zero cell, right? And then we'll try to connect the neighbor islands in four directions here. So we're gonna have like answer equals 0, and for I in range M, so for J in range N, right? So now we're looking for the zero cell, zero value here. So if this one equals to 0, okay, and then we will we'll look for like four directions. Right, so this time we need to check all four directions, right? Directions. So same thing. I'm just going to copy and paste this one, these two parts here. So, but to do that, there's a little things we need to be careful here, because you know, although we have a zero here and we have four directions, you know, some of the ones, they may belong to the same islands, right? Because let's, for example, if the island is like this, if the island is like this, let's say this is the first island, right? And then this is 0, And the second island is like this. Okay, so this is the second island. Right? So here, even though we have seen four ones in each directions, but actually those four ones only belong to two islands, right? So this three one down on the left, down and right, they all belong to the same island. And this one belongs to one island, right? Yeah, and it could be also even more extreme, right? So we it could be have this one island, right? There's only one island because that's the island, right? So there's only one zeros right in the middle. So all four ones belong to the same island. So that's why, you know, here when we accumulate the size of the islands, we also need to check if that root has been the root we're looking right now, if it has been seen before. That's why for each of the zeros, I'm going to have like a seen root set here and then I'm going to have like a total equal to zero. So the total, so this thing is going to be a total size, right, on four directions. Okay, so I'm also going to just copy this part because the check is exactly the same here, right? Now, what do we have? I'll just have a key here. So the key is like new I times m plus j, right? And then we're gonna have like a root. I'm going to have like a root equals to the find of key. So I need to find the key, the root for this island, right? Because we are having this check this one here. And then I'm gonna have if the root not in seen root, right? And then we know, okay, so this is the new island. We can count. So that's why we have a seen. Now we have total plus the size of root. So remember, so this size is also the key of the size array is also the root. That's why I use the root to find the size and the add it, accumulate it to the total here. And then don't forget to mark this root to be to the scene. Add it to the scene root here so that we won't double count the same islands. Right, and then so that's the total size for the current zeros, and here and in the end, we also need to update the answer, right? So basically, since we're getting the maximum, right, the maximum size, so and that's the total size for this zero, basically by changing this zero to one, right? So we have size and then total. Right. And then in the end, we can simply return the answer plus one because I didn't account to this. Or we can initialize this thing with one. No, sorry. It should be zero. So in the end, we add this thing to one so that we account this the zero itself. Right, the zero will also need to be changed to one. That's why we do a plus one here. And yeah, that's the basic logic, but there is like a special case. So what is a special case? The special case is like all ones here, right? Because for all, if there is no zeros, it will not even go into this. It will never find like a zeros. That's why the answer will be zero. But the answer will be one. But it actually should be the total number of the cells. That's why to handle that, I mean, the easiest way is for me, I just introduce a new flag here, right? Has zero. I just use has zero equals to false. And then here, every time when we have like sees the zeros here, you know, first thing first, I set this has zero to true. Okay. And before return this answer plus one, I do a check. If not, has zero. Okay, I simply return m times n, right? And if after this one, it means that we have seen at least one zero. So that's why we can trust this answer here. Okay, cool. So I think we are ready to run the code now. Total reference. Oh, total size. I'm sorry. So here should be total size. Submit. 3 and 4. 3 and 4. We have an answer plus one. So this one, so this one fails. Interesting. So there must be a place I. All right, maybe here. I saw it here. Should be new J here. At least this one is definitely wrong. So let's try to run the code again. Now we have five. That's weird. There must be somewhere that I mistyped. I mistyped the new I and new J here. Oh yes. So here, same thing for this new should be new J. Okay, so at least this one passed. Let's try to resubmit. All right, cool. So it's passed. Yeah, so for the time and space complexity, right? So the time and space complexity, since the union find, we can treat the both find and union to be O1 time complexity. That's why the total complexity for this problem is simply just O n square, because we have a nested for loop here, and then here we have two loop here, which is a constant, and then here we also have like a O n square, right? So here we have a times 4, which is also a constant factor. That's why total complexity is O n square, and the space complexity is, of course, it's also a O n square. Yeah, actually it's not a O n square, sorry, it's a m times n, but since they all bounded with the same like 50 here, so it should be O n square. Yeah, I think it's safe to say that time is this, space is also a O n square. And okay, so for this problem, I think it's not a very hard problem. I think the as long as you can figure out how can you find all the islands, and how can you store the root of each island and the size of each island and the size of each island. The rest it's like more like the implement like more implementation focusing, where you just need to loop through all the zero cell, and then you will try to union on four directions, and then you just summarize the total size, and then here's some like special case check, and then you simply return the answer plus one. Yep, I think that's pretty much it is for this problem, and yeah, thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Stay tuned. See you guys soon. Bye bye.